and Dean Dr. Anuradha Parashar. So here I request Dr. Anuradha Parashar ma'am to introduce the speaker of today's session. Over to you ma'am.
A very good evening to one and all. Welcome to all the participants to Samvad series at MIT World Peace University, Pune, India. And a hearty welcome to all esteemed members from academia, industry, society, deans, directors, principals, HODs of various colleges and schools from across India who are attending Samvad series along with their faculty and student. We also welcome faculty, staff and student participants from MIT World Peace University, Pune. Those of you who are attending MIT WP Samvad series for the first time, just a few lines for them about our university. MIT World Peace University is situated in Pune, which is the cultural capital of Maharashtra in India. Our university is popularly known as MIT WPU. Our university, MIT WPU, is the center for scientific, educational, technological, and spiritual development. And MIT WPU offers UG, PG, PhD certificate and diploma programs in liberal arts, fine arts, media and journalism, engineering, pharmacy, management, design, political leadership, governance, education, law, and computer sciences. And at any given point of time, more than 60,000 students are pursuing various courses across 65 institutes of MIT. Now, coming back to Samvad subject for today, some of you might have visited Sikkim, and good number of participants might be aware that Sikkim is a small state and is one of the most beautiful states of India. Sikkim is also respected being the first organic state. And when we think of Sikkim, there are so many things which comes in our mind, the beautiful scenic scene, the cascading rainfalls and the green, the fluorescent flora and fauna, and you're just in the lap of nature. So this is one aspect, and the other aspect is Sikkim has been facing various challenges since centuries, whether it is somewhat remoteness, isolation, not that easy location, it's too hilly and mountainous terrains, heavy rains, seismic zones, landslides, sinking area, stone pelting, transportation and connectivity issues, or let's say limited facility and resources, etc. And all these are regular and daily life challenges for Sikkim state and its people. And these challenges, we can understand, has further multiplied exponentially due to COVID-19, as Sikkim's economy is heavily dependent on tourism. Sikkim is a state where tourist footfall is around the year. And on an average, tourist ratio at times is higher than state population. Due to COVID-19 and nationwide lockdown, we all are aware that tourism has been badly impacted and many lives and livelihoods are at stake. Considering the daily life challenges that Sikkim administration and people faces on day-to-day basis, we always feel proud and always feel like saluting all at Northeast and all at Sikkim that in spite of all natural challenges, geographical challenges, daily life hardships and difficulties is the Sikkim government and its people faces every day, yet they are very, very conscious about the environment. At present, all other countries and states, they're counting on daily basis how many COVID-19 positive cases are there. And this is happening with all of us since this month, March 2020. We are witnessing increase in corona positive cases every day. We all somewhere are feeling scared, maybe depressed, confused, sometimes clueless also. What is the future and where to see the future? And here's a state like Sikkim, a unique state. Even before coming online for Samvad series in the morning and even just now, I've checked the status on Arogya Setu app and its state confirmed corona cases in Sikkim. I repeat, confirmed corona cases in Sikkim, zero. Yes, it's zero. You heard it right. Now we see ray of light. For sure, Sikkim state has done some miracle, which is worth sharing. High appreciation, COVID-19 pandemic. I think I also feel like, wow, it's magic. The state of Sikkim remains untouched by the coronavirus. Such a small state. The sea's footfall of tourists from all parts of country and the world, and tourist footfall at times is higher than its actual population. What is that shield which has protected Sikkim from COVID-19? Probably, this effective shield is the Sikkim administration, visionaries, government, policymakers, planners, politicians, officials, and yes, the people at large. See, the self-discipline probably, that's really great. Another important aspect to note about Sikkim is that despite having shared borders with Nepal, Bhutan, and China, where the threat of coronavirus was detected and declared much earlier, Sikkim is not having a single positive corona case. From depth of my heart, I feel so happy talking this point, which for sure I would love to repeat again and again. I repeat, Sikkim is not having a single corona positive case. And I wish and pray to Divine Almighty that this situation, which is not having a single corona positive case, this status, I pray, come to India and to global society at the earliest. We all want to see this day at the earliest. And I'm sure this question is there in the minds of all, and also amongst all the participants attending this MITWQ Sampad series as well. And the question is, why and how state of Sikkim is COVID-19 exception? I'm sure all participants, and for that matter, everyone is thinking how Sikkim has managed this. This is the context for today's Sampad series. It is indeed my honor and proud privilege to introduce young, dynamic Shri Tushar Nikhare, IAS Additional District Collector, West District Sikkim. Mr. Nikhare has done BTech from College of Engineering, Pune. He previously worked with IBM India Private Limited and Reserve Bank of India. While in the administrative services, his previous postings have been as Assistant Collector, Namchi South Sikkim District, and Subdivisional Magistrate, Gezing West Sikkim. This is just a very short introduction to few of his achievements at a very young age. He has made so many remarkable achievements. We feel happy that Mr. Tushar is here with us as distinguished speaker for Sampad series. With this brief introduction, on my behalf and on behalf of Honorable Executive President, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Honorable Pro-Vice Chancellor, faculty, staff, students of MIT World Peace University, Pune, we extend warm welcome to Shri Tushar Nikhare to MIT WPU Sampad CD. Mr. Nikhare will be sharing with us today his observation, experiences, and insights in and around the theme, challenges and opportunities in front of administration in dealing with COVID-19. Nikhare sir, I want to tell you that all participants, they are quite keen and eager to listen to you and wish to know, actually they want to see, where is that magic stick and the magical chair which Sikkim State has used as precautionary, timely, proactive steps to prevent entry of this deadly virus, the most fearing and scary name today, coronavirus, so successfully and for keeping Sikkim as green state. This is a great and historic success story for all at Sikkim and all, for all of us across the globe. And it's a very good research case, I think, worth emulation by everyone. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come closer to the most awaited time. It's time to invite Shri Tushar Nikhare for interaction with Sampad series participants. Sir, we invite you for interaction with Sampad series participants. Over to you, Tushar Nikhare, sir. Thank you.
Thank you for that generous introduction, ma'am. I think you have done, you know, you have made my part much easier by speaking so good, so many good things about Sikkim that I don't think so I have explained much. So the introductory part has been done in a, taken care of in a great manner. I hope I'm audible and visible, ma'am.
Yes, you are audible and visible. Yes.
Okay. So let us start with this. Let me thank, you know, MIT WPU for giving me this great opportunity to present the side of state.